Okay. Thank you. You must let us give people hope forward. In Jesus' mighty name. a new rhythm of a new sound, the sound of the Holy Spirit, the sound of victory, the sound of joy, the new sound of the kingdom. Yes, Lord, we command the ground, we command the elements of creation, every element of your creation. My God, my Lord, you command the winds, you command the rain. Hey, who said it cannot happen, Lord, when you have not said it? When the elements of creation choose to fight for you, then everything becomes positive. Who will send the wind to attack you? When the elements of creation God created and the Bible says in 1:04, in Psalms 1:04, verse 18, verse 10, the Bible says again in Psalms 1:118, the winds are my messengers, praise the Lord. The winds are my messengers. He who rides on the clouds, he who rides on the storms, he's gonna make it happen for you. Now speak to the ground. If the earth is fighting against you, let it hear the word of God. You will not die a premature death. You will not go down in the ground. Let that earth produce fire. Refuse you in Jesus' name, but only to produce good crops for you.
You raise the name of the living God. Then I was speaking, but as my sound comes back to me, so I pray that it's going to happen. Thank you, in Jesus' mighty name. May God bless you, mighty. As a greater leader than the ministers of this place,
pray that you
have really but it's by the grace of God. You ministers who have been standing in the sessions of Tuesday, I really want to thank God for your lives. To stand here and lead us as the pastors in the presence of God.
In the month of June.
love of God.
And I believe God has given me a message for you. concerning the month of June. Praise the name of the living God. We know that He has already given us a word of
year.
And we are holding on that.
I've
gone ahead of you. I will level the mountains before you, all the hills. And I will make the crooked paths very smooth for you. So it doesn't matter where you've been walking, and you've been walking on thorns and briars. He said, I will set them on fire. And you will walk on the smooth road. Praise the name of the living God. And you've been doing something good. I have a message for you. I had it last night as I was just meditating, crying to God, what you want me to tell your people. On top of the message that we are still on, that He has given us this month of June, we are still on the topic, kindness beyond the expectation. Because that is the message He has given us for June. That in the months we are going to receive kindness beyond our expectation. Honor and royalty are going ahead of us. So we receive grace that we don't even deserve. Praise the name of the living God. You are about to receive something you don't deserve. You are about to receive something you don't qualify.
That is one
secret that your oil in your pot, your flour will never run dry. When the economy of the world is collapsing down, we have a system support that is not of the world. Our support system is from above. Our economy is not of the world. Our budget does not depend on how things are like the way we live.
But But then they are not remembering the world. They think in the great places where they are sitting, that's where they are picking the thanksgiving, that's where they are picking their prices, that's where they are honored. By doing that, it's not in the honor of God. As they do that, there is nothing God is turning back to them. They are opening the doors of disaster again. When I saw this one coming in the bags and the offerings, and I said, I will not touch anything of that man. Because Elisha was aware and he knew that that small girl, the one who is nobody in his house, has not been recognized and appreciated by him.
It is time we honor the place where we know we have encountered God. Do things not because you do them for the human beings, but do them for the Lord. And always allow the Spirit of God to navigate life for you. People thought maybe Elisha was a foolish man. But he was not a foolish man because he knew that something was not right with this offering. If Naaman had humbled himself and just appreciated the young girl, because if it was not that girl to know, he was going to die of the ripples. Today you walk with a friend and you introduce that friend to a place and this friend chooses to become your enemy. They forget that through you they are connected there. Even if you are nobody, but you deserve to be appreciated. And if that kind of appreciation goes to God, and when you do that, God will bless you and preserve your life and continue to open doors before you, because He knows that your heart, just things the way you wanted them to be done. I pray that God is going to help us. All of us to recognize a place or somebody you did good to in Jesus' mighty name. Praise the name of the living God. It might look small, but God is remembering it. And He's going to reward you. Is He not who said it? I am the one who rewards those who seek me diligently. The one who rewards the good works. Because at the end of the day, I am the one who tests the good works. As the book goes through the fire, before it comes to the bucket, even our works are tested. Let us check and see why do we do certain things. What is the reason and the motive behind it? Why am I betraying my friend?
What am I chasing?
What am I pursuing? Praise the name of the living God. The pursuit of the kindness. I told you I introduced this message as we slept. I don't want anything to confuse you, and let's just get to the word of God. Quickly run with the book of 2 Samuel chapter 9. We looked at one of the first stages of this sermon, and we were able to go through them. And today we are going to stop. If I take you back, the scripture reading was 2 Samuel 9:1-11. Praise the name of the Lord. From the life of King David. Praise the Lord. This passage teaches us profound lessons like what we learn and why do we understand, what do we gain when we go through and deal in this text. Praise the Lord.
In this passage, it
praise the Lord. You may be asking yourself, what am I called to do? What am I supposed to be doing in this company? Why am I here in this office? Glory to God. If you can only learn how to extend God's love, to reflect God in that job you have, in that place where you are, in that marriage you've been blessed, as you raise those children, reflect God's love. Ministry where you serve from. Don't take it lightly. Don't take it lightly. Every opportunity you have in life, what do you reflect? Who do you work for? Who do you serve? Praise the Lord. So one day was attacked badly and surrounded by many enemies. And the time of deliverance to be rescued and helped was near him. I want to prophesy over your life that today you're living here with the help of God. And Joshua looked around and saw the angel who came to help him. But because he did not expect anything good to be on his side, he did not expect that I'm going to be helped. He was terrified because he was surrounded by the great men and all these who are his enemies. Praise the Lord. But without him knowing that it was the day of his deliverance, it was the day, the moment, the time has come for him to be helped. He was now wrestling, was fighting against the helper who has come to deliver him. It's very important to know sometimes the people around us.
What?
or call it.
Thank you.
the Lord.
Thank you. Sí. Yeah.